Several years ago, I decided that I really wanted to start taking slide guitar more seriously. And to do that, I figured I might as well go ahead and start learning an open tuning like open E. I tried open G for a while with some minimal success, but once I went into open E, the whole sort of open chord slide guitar tuning thing really clicked for me. Started watching a lot of videos on YouTube, learning from it, listening to people like Dwayne Allman and transcribing solos. And over time I got so comfortable with open E that I felt it was time to start gigging with it and writing with it, and I did. And then about a year ago, year and a half ago, I decided to try open D, which is just open E, but a whole step down. You're tuning the whole guitar down a whole step. And that was a light bulb moment for me. This has become one of, if not my favorite alternate tunings for guitar, so much so that I leave at least one guitar around in open D because it's pretty much my favorite tuning to play in. So today's video, I'm gonna show you everything you need to know to start playing and working in open D tuning and why I think you should take a guitar and leave it in open D. But before we jump into the video, a quick announcement, we're running a sale on all of my video courses. You can find links to those in the description box down below. That's the Nashville Number System course, the Tone course, and my most recent course, Fretboard Fundamentals. You can find those all on RhettShullGuitarCourses.com, as well as some affiliate links to some of the gear that I use to make today's video. All right, let's grab a guitar, tune it down, and learn about open D. Guitar into open D, it's a pretty simple process. This tuning is essentially the same thing as open E, just tuned down a whole step. Now, if you're not familiar, open E or open D essentially means we're tuning our guitar to play an E major or a D major chord in this position. So if your guitar is tuned in standard E, A, D, G, B, E tuning, and you were to play this chord shape here, you'd get an E major chord. So what we're doing is tuning the guitar to essentially play that chord for us. Now, open D takes that standard tuning and drops it down a whole step to D standard. Now, I made a whole video on D standard that you can check out here, but all we're gonna do is tune the guitar to play a D major chord in this first position. So the notes are as follows. Low sixth string is D, fifth string is A, fourth string is D, third string is F sharp, second string is A, first string is D. So when you strum all of the notes together, you get. Now, you should notice one of the first things about this tuning that's amazing is how lush and powerful and beautiful the guitar sounds when it's tuned down a whole step. I talked about this in the D standard video, but I'm sort of surprised that more players don't rely on a whole step down tuning for their guitars because it sounds beautiful. I love it. So essentially what we have here is a major triad, root, major third, and fifth stacked together so that when you play the open strings, you get the major chords. We have root, fifth, root, third, fifth, root, major triad. What's cool about that is essentially now you can play any major chord anywhere on the neck in just about any key by barring. So here is our four chord G major. Here's our five chord A major. Now, to play a minor chord, what we need to do is take this major third here and drop it down a whole step to a minor third. So to demonstrate that, I'm gonna go to our sixth chord, which is B minor in the key of D. And obviously, if I play that, I've got a B major, so I need to take this down there. So there's a minor shape. Now, if you're just starting out or you wanna simplify these chord shapes, just play the root on the sixth string and the major or minor third. And to practice this, we can play the harmonized major scale using those simple, just dyad chord shapes. So here's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, one. Now this is a really great way to start learning this tuning because that exercise is gonna teach you where your basic chords are for any diatonic chord progression, a song that's in the key of D major. So if we had a 6-4-1-5, you could play it like this. Now, if you want to go a step beyond that, you can start finding triad shapes in other positions on the neck. So for instance, here is a 4 chord. Here's a 5 chord. Here's a 6 chord. Another thing I love doing in a tuning like this is utilizing the open strings to kind of spice up the chords that I'm already playing. So I'm gonna play a 6-5-4 progression going from B minor down to A major down to G major. And I'm only gonna play the roots and the third of each chord and utilize the open strings alongside it to get this sort of open, ethereal, airy kind of sound. All right, so chances are a good number of you watching this video are interested in open D for the slide uses of it. And it certainly is a great tuning for slide. In fact, that's primarily how I use it. And I've actually come to prefer this over open E for a few reasons. One, I think it just sounds better. Like we talked about earlier in the video, and I talked about in my D standard video, when you tune down a whole step, it does something to the sound of the guitar. The pickups respond differently, the amp responds differently, and you get this just beautiful. Really swampy, greasy kind of sound, which I love. Now, if you're new to slide, there's a few things you can start off with in this tuning to kind of get your feet wet. The first is just a simple 1-4-5 blues progression. And all we're gonna do is essentially play the 4 chord and the 5 chord, but instead of barring with our fingers, we're just gonna bar with the slide. Now you can do this in a number of different ways, a number of different rhythms. There's countless examples of blues progressions played with slide and different styles and feels and times. You can look all that stuff up online. But there's another thing to think about when it comes to improvising and kind of getting some chops together with slide, and that is using the open position major and minor pentatonic scale shapes that are available right here in this open tuning. For example, literally all of that is based right here around the third fret, between the open strings and the third fret. So to start off, you can just fret with your fingers. And the key here is to utilize the open strings alongside the pentatonic licks that you're playing to get that more authentic kind of sound. And you can get a major sound simply by moving between the second and fourth frets here. Now, this is one of my favorite ways to practice in a tuning and kind of get these ideas down. There's so many melodic ways to play in this major and minor position here. It's almost like songs can kind of just fall out of the guitar when you're in this tuning. That's part of why I love it so much. Then once you're comfortable with the scale shapes, put the slide on and start moving between those positions. Thank you. One of the other reasons I love this open D tuning is because we're putting the guitar down a whole step, it gives us more real estate to work with to play in other keys. So for instance, if you want to get into that Duane Allman style of slide, like Statesboro Blues, I actually prefer playing it in open D rather than open E because it puts you right here in this 12th position, which is a little bit easier to visualize and kind of wrap your head around, at least in my opinion. And when it comes to playing in other keys, then you can just capo up. So for instance, playing in open E, all you really have to do is throw a capo on the second fret, and now we're in open E. Now the trade-off when you're working here is you are losing a little bit of real estate up here at the very, very top end of the neck. So if you have to have that, maybe you retune, but I've actually started gigging this way. With Noah Guthrie and Good Trouble, I play a lot of the songs on slide and we range in different keys from E to E flat to D. So I started putting one guitar in open D and then just capoing up throughout the show, and it's made my life so much easier because we don't have roadies or anything. I'm loading all my own gear in and out and only having to bring one other guitar that's tuned to an open tuning like this. Really helps out my back. Plus you can play in keys like E flat, which has a really nice sound in an open tuning like this. Now, a few words of advice here in terms of setup. If you are gonna put a guitar in open D, I would recommend doing a few things. One, I'd go up a string gauge. So if you normally play nines, I'd go to tens or from tens to 11s, something that's gonna hold up to the lower tension a little bit better. Also, a guitar that doesn't have a tremolo system on it like this Firebird does is usually the way to go. Now, I've actually had good success with this Maestro style trim here. For whatever reason, it seems pretty stable, which is interesting because these are notoriously bad, notoriously unstable. In fact, a lot of people would just pull these off of these old Firebirds, but this one has done pretty good. And I'd recommend taking one of your guitars, putting it in open D and leaving it there for a few weeks or a few months and pick it up, start playing it, start practicing with it, start trying to write on it, come up with new ideas and new melodies. This is a great tool for busting out of ruts in your playing. It completely shakes off all of the normal licks and ideas that you tend to play over and over and over again because you're in a completely new tuning that sounds completely different. It's lower than what most of us are used to playing in. So this is a fantastic tool for getting new ideas out and onto the fretboard. So there you go. That's everything you need to know about open D tuning. If you enjoyed today's video, let me know by leaving a like and a comment down below. What do you like to play in these open tunings, or are you just starting out? I'd love to know. Don't forget, all of my video courses are currently on sale via the links in the description box down below, so pick one of those up. And thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Rhett Shull, and remember, there is no plan B. ¶¶